Good morning and welcome to our worship for this half term. We're going to be looking this half term at the theme of perseverance. And I want to begin by giving you a definition of what perseverance is. It is when we carry on where we face difficulties, the possibility of failure, or people or situations that might get in the way of what we are trying to achieve, but we keep going regardless. I want to look this morning at the example of somebody that is an athlete. Now, an athlete such as the one that you see in this picture will try to be the very best in order to win a medal, to win a prize. And I want you to think about what they might do in order to achieve that success. Just for a moment, talk to the people on your table, and I'm only going to give you a moment or two, but what kind of things might they need to do? What kind of things might they need help with? What kind of things might they need to give up in order to succeed? My examples of what they might need include that they need to practice in order to get good at the sport that they're trying to achieve. Somebody that is an athlete will train for many, many hours before they perfect the skill and become the very best, the very top of their game. They probably need to change what they eat, and they need to make sure that the food that they're eating will support the goal that they're trying to achieve, so that they can be slim and healthy, and so that they can run the very fastest or swim the fastest or whatever sport it might be. I want you to think of it this way. If you were trying to learn about the Great Fire of London, as some of you have been doing recently, would you read a book about tennis? In order to achieve the goal that you're trying to aim for, you need to be looking at the right things. You need to put the right things into your mind in order to help you. And that's a bit like eating the right food in order to achieve the goal that you're aiming for. Wearing the right clothes. Well, athletes will wear special clothes for their sport, but in the same way, we need the right equipment to help us to succeed, to help us to persevere. If I were to read a new book that was more difficult than one I had read before, I might need a dictionary, or I might need to talk to my parents, or I might need to email a teacher to ask for help with words that I'm finding difficult. I might then need to read the book a second time in order to fully understand what I'm reading, but it would be very fruitful because the contents of that book would help me to grow and help me to learn new things. That would be the goal, the thing that I was heading towards. And in the same way, an athlete will aim to win the gold medal, to be the very best that they possibly can, and if possible, to be better than everyone else. Paul, when he writes in the Bible, puts it like this. He says that we should forget what is behind and strain for what is ahead. And he says of himself, I press on to win the prize which God has called me heavenwards in Christ Jesus. For Paul, the prize that he was aiming for was a better relationship with God. He knew that there were things in his past that would get in the way, things that would make him feel guilty, things that would make him feel sad, things that would make him feel that he wasn't capable of being loved by God. But he would forget those things because he knew how much God loved him, and he would fix his eyes on the prize of having a perfect relationship with God. So let's go back for a moment to that example of reading a new book. Perhaps we found reading difficult in the past and we worried when we picked the book up that we'll not be able to do it. Well, forget what is behind. pick up the book with fresh energy and fresh vigour. Look to the finishing line. Look and think what it will be like to finish reading that book. And then press on, using all the tools and all the skills that are available to you to achieve that goal. We can take any event or any situation in our life and apply the same tools, pressing on, trying our very hardest, and forgetting the mistakes and the failures of the past in order to succeed in the future. Not letting anything from before hold us back, but pressing on to win the goal. But what about the times in our lives when we don't come first, when we don't get the gold medal, when we're not the best? There are many times in our lives that there are going to be people that are better than us at something. Now, we could grumble and we could get upset, or we could refuse to have a go, because if we're not going to be the best, what's the point? But we can gain so much through persevering and through trying to achieve something that is difficult for us. Let's watch this video together from the Olympics in the 1980s. In it, we see some people running a race. All of them want to be number one, all want to win. And look how fast they run. As they run, one of the people in the race is injured. Now he's holding the back of his leg. Now he hobbles. Everyone else is running towards the finish line. Everyone else is finishing. It would be so tempting, wouldn't it, to give up and not to go on, but he gets to his feet and he runs with all of the energy that he's got left, hobbling towards the finish line. But he's not alone in running his race, because his dad has noticed how much pain he is in and comes to support him. First of all, saying to him, "Why don't you give up?" But he can see his son is determined to carry on. So his son puts his arm around his father's shoulder, and his father says to anybody that tries to stop his son, "Go away, he's going to finish. Give him a chance to do the thing that set out." And as they walk towards the finish line, you could say that he's because he didn't come first, but still, and as he heads towards the finish line, people try to persuade him to stop, but his father says, "No, I'm going to support him and I'm going to help him." And as he crosses the finish line, look at all the cameras, look at all the people that are watching. I don't see him as having failed, because he's achieved his goal. He's got to the end of his race. No matter how much it hurt, he's persevered. He's got to the end. So for all of us, we should aim to be the very best that we possibly can. We should persevere. And perhaps there will be times that we will be first and we will be better than the people around us. But it's not about being the best. It's about finishing well. And sometimes that means accepting help from other people as we journey along the way. Let's pray as we finish our time of worship together. Lord God, thank you that we are surrounded by friends and teachers and family, and all sorts of people that want to help us to succeed in life. When things get difficult, help us to persevere and to press on. Help us to believe in ourselves and to achieve the very best that we can. And in those times in our lives when things are very difficult and we feel alone, help us to know that you are our Heavenly Father, and that when we speak to you and ask for your help, you will be there to walk alongside us and to help us. And for that, we give you thanks. Amen. I'm going to finish with a song now.
Nothing's gonna stop us now.